Eliana. My name is Eliana Anderson.
My name is Alicia Anderson.
Once upon a time, there was
a bunny?
No. One day, Jesus went to Jerusalem on his donkey. They all gathered twigs and they waved them in the air.
They threw their coats on the ground.
Hosanna, Hosanna.
It's the Son of God.
Then on the last night with his friends, he had a meal with them. They ate the Last Supper. He said that to remember him every time they had that supper. He went to the garden to pray
Gethsemane.
But the disciples fell asleep with the donkey. After Jesus prayed, mean girls took them away.
So dogs were bad.
Jesus said that he was God's son. They didn't like it at all. The people got so mad that they put Jesus on a cross. His mom and his friends were very sad because they loved him. He died because he wanted to forgive our sins. They brought him off the cross to a cave that had a stone so he couldn't get out. Saturday, they were all sad and they were all scared. On a Sunday, they went to look and they saw he was not in there anymore. The tomb was empty. An angel told them that Jesus had risen from the dead. The women came running to the disciples to tell them, but they would not believe them. Jesus came in the room. They were all surprised and they were all happy. Since they were so happy, they had a month together. After they had so much fun, Jesus went onto a top of a hill and he waved goodbye all to his friends. He said, "I will come back someday. While I'm gone, tell everybody about me." And he went up to heaven. The disciples, they told everybody that Jesus would always forgive them. Now I know that he loves me and my little sister Alicia and my mom and my dad, and he loves everybody. That's why me and my sister love to dress up and go to church and be pretty as we celebrate Easter. By celebrating, we say to Jesus, "Thank you and we love you."
Good morning. And what a beautiful good morning this is. It was really good, has been really good to see many of you either at church in our worship services, a few of you if I have been around at Team Kid, but I saw many of you at our recent Easter egg hunt, and it was so fun to actually be together again. And as we think about Easter and we think about all the things that go along with it, eggs and candy and Easter baskets, and the thing that I want to share with you today is about Jesus' crucifixion on the cross and his resurrection. I grew up on a farm, and one of the many animals that we had were sheep, and like the good shepherd that Jesus is, my dad, the farmer, would always make sure that the sheep were where they were supposed to be, and that he would count his sheep and make sure that we had all the right amount back in the barn by the end of the evening. Jesus is like that. When we stray away from him, he looks for us. And when we're found, just like when we find Easter eggs, we're excited. And when Jesus finds us, actually when we find him, how excited he really is. In Luke chapters 22 through 24, the story of Jesus' death, resurrection, are found fairly complete there. Some things that just to remind you of, some of the characters and some of the Bible personalities that we've talked about, some of the disciples, Peter included, had told Jesus that he would always follow him. He would never say that he was not a follower of Jesus. We'll get back to that in just a minute. When Jesus went to the Mount of Olives to pray, he took some of his disciples, some of his very close friends, with him, and he asked them to pray with him. And but what did they do? They fell asleep. And in doing so, Jesus woke them up and reminded them they had said that they would stay with him. Again, they fell asleep. One of the disciples that had been following Jesus for this period of time while he was doing his ministry here on earth was Judas. And he actually betrayed Jesus. He told the soldiers who Jesus was by planting a kiss on him when they went into the group. And so they knew who exactly Jesus was. Then they were able to arrest him and take him off for a very unfair trial. And during this period of time, Peter, that we talked about just a bit ago, had been asked many times, you know, you were with that man, you were with that man. And he's going, no, not me, not me. And again, and again, until finally, when the rooster crowed, he realized that Jesus had been right, that he would deny him. Peter had a change of heart and actually became a very outspoken follower of Jesus. The crowd around Jesus with the soldiers, they laughed at him, they mocked him, they made him a crown of thorns that they put on his head that made his head bleed. They put a sword in his side. It was a very painful way for Jesus to be not only tried, but to be persecuted. And along the way, they said, "Oh, you said you were the king of the Jews. Why don't you use your earthly kingly powers and free yourself?" That wasn't what Jesus was about. Jesus was here for a reason. He was here because God sent him for a specific reason. Unfairly, Jesus was hung on the cross between two thieves, one who made fun of Jesus and one who asked for mercy, who asked forgiveness. And Jesus so freely and so clearly forgave that thief on the cross and said, "Yes, you will be with me in heaven because you believe that I actually am the Son of God." Jesus died on the cross. He was taken for burial in a tomb that was given to them by Joseph of Arimathea, a good man who believed that Jesus was the Messiah. Because it was Friday evening and it was the beginning of the Sabbath, his body was only partially prepared for burial. And when I say Good Friday, it's Good Friday because it's good for us, because Jesus, who never sinned, who did not have to die on the cross, he did not have to die at all. He had no sin, but he was willing to sacrifice himself and take all of our sins upon himself. And he made it possible at that point in time that then we could go directly to God through him and talk. In the past, when believers had wanted to talk to God, they had to go through the priests who went into the temple, and they were the go-between, and a blood sacrifice, an animal sacrifice, had to be provided for them to actually talk and petition their prayers to God. But Jesus made this possible that you and I, because of his blood sacrifice, we don't have to bring a smelly, stinky sacrifice. We have to do more, no more than just bow our heads and talk to him, and we can talk to God the Father through him. And you can only imagine how sad all of Jesus' friends were that they had watched all of these things happen. Jesus had gone from being the man who walked with them, broke bread with them, shared food with them, spent time with them, listened to them, and told them all the things that they needed to know. Even though they didn't fully understand it, he told them the things that they needed to know. All of his friends were very sad when his body was taken off the cross and taken down to go to the tomb to be buried. The people who followed Jesus' body to the tomb did some very quick preparations. And we know that there were some women who actually did some of the very quick preparations so that then they could return after the Sabbath to finish preparing his body totally to be buried. But not the end of the story yet, because when the women arrived that early that Sunday morning to finish their process of preparing Jesus' body for full burial, he wasn't there. And they were scared and they were shocked and in disbelief, and very hard to imagine that even though these angels who were sitting there told them, "Why are you looking for him? He's not here. He told you he wasn't going to be here." Like us, we don't understand everything that God has in store for us. We don't understand all the things about God's word. But Jesus was preparing them, and they began then to somewhat understand. And even when they saw him briefly in various places on the road, he appeared to some of the disciples who were in the upper room. He appeared to other groups of people for a short period of time. Jesus then said, "You know, my job now is not to stay with you here physically. I am going to go to heaven to prepare a place for you so that when you come, when you believe in your heart that I am actually your Savior, that when you die, that you can come to heaven and be with God." We talk about Easter. We talk about the fact, we talk about eggs a lot. And eggs have various parts. And the three parts that we can take a look at are the shell, the white part of the egg, and the yolk. And just like an egg, God has three parts: God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. God the Father, God the Son, who died for us, sent the Holy Spirit then to be with us so that until we are called home to be with him, the Holy Spirit can live in us. Very simple for us to ask. And nothing new. Many of you have heard it multiple times. The ABCs. If we admit, we believe, and we confess. We admit that we're sinners. We believe that Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And we confess, yes, we are sinners. We can live with him forever. We're found. Just like we go out and find those eggs, we've been found because we have accepted Christ into our hearts. I hope that through this Easter season that you will have the fun times with your family. I actually hope that you can see more of your family. I hope you can be out. I hope you can be about. I'm getting very eager for us to have our normal routines where we can come together and have Bible lessons together and actually be together. But in the meantime, I want you throughout this particular few days between now and actual Easter Sunday that you think about a few things. Think about these few things about Jesus, that he spent time with all of us and that he is going to continue to be with us. In the last part of Luke chapter 24, the very last verses, when they led them out to the vicinity of Bethany, he lifted his hands and he blessed them. And while he was blessing them, he left them and was taken up into heaven. And they worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. He ascended. He went up into heaven. And let's remember those great promises that we're here and that God is with us through Jesus, through the Holy Spirit. And I hope that you will have a great week, and I'm very anxious to see all of you. I miss you and I love you.
From a throne of endless glory to till that stone was moved for good, for the Lamb had conquered death, and the dead rose from their tombs, and the air.